Is private browsing really private? Hi everyone, this is Leo Notenboom for askleo.com. The short answer? No, not in the way you're thinking it should be. Here's the question I got. I use private browsing mode in my web browser to keep my online activities private. I mentioned that to a friend and he said that it wasn't private at all. If he's right, what's the point? So, you're both right, and you're both wrong. There's a line in the sand, and if you are under that line, or before that line, you're private. But if you're beyond it, you're not. Let me explain what I mean. Private browsing, also known as incognito mode, affects only what happens on your computer. That's it. So the line, if you will, is your network connection. Anything that happens in front of that line, in other words, on your computer, yes, that is affected by in private or incognito mode. However, anything that happens anywhere else, your router, other computers on your network, the services you use, and so forth, that's not impacted at all. What private mode actually does is simply this. When you open a private window, here's what happens. Any cookies that may already be in your normal session are not made available. That's why, for example, if you're logged into an account and you open an in private window, you have to log into it again because the cookies that maintain your login state were not carried over. Most browsers will disable all the extensions. Some have the ability to say, yes, let this extension run in private mode, but by default, most extensions are disabled. And some browsers, especially more modern ones, that also provide a certain amount of tracking protection, will make sure that the tracking protection is not only on, but set to its highest level. So, when you close a private mode window, what happens is any cookies that were actually created during the private session are deleted. Any history that was accumulated as part of the private session is deleted. And any cache files that are accumulated as part of that in private session are deleted. What that means is once you leave your in private mode session, there should be no traces of what you did on your computer. I have to reiterate, on your computer. What private mode does not do is it does not hide what you're doing from others elsewhere. Your network traffic is completely unaffected. Your ISP can still see what you're up to. The websites you're visiting have no idea that you're incognito. They can still identify you by various means, not necessarily limited to cookies. The search history saved online, for example, if you happen to, in your in-private session, sign in to Google, then Google will retain everything that you're doing as part of your online record. Any malware that happens to be on your machine, yeah, it can see what you're doing. And any files that are deleted after you exit your private mode session, in theory, could be recovered. The bottom line here is that in private mode does a fine job of basically keeping your tracks clean on your computer. But it does nothing, absolutely nothing, to keep you private online. That's not the point. The point is to basically keep your computer clean. When would you want to use private mode? Well, obviously, if you're in a family situation and you're kind of sort of trying to hide your tracks from somebody in your family, clearly that makes sense. In reality, the more general case is if you're using a public computer. If you are doing something, say, at a public library, you want to not leave any traces of what you've been up to. Private mode is perfect for that. I tend to use private mode quite a bit because I want to be able to log into the same account in multiple cases. For example, when I sign into my Ask Leo account, I'm an administrator for the site, so I get all of the administrative tools, I've got everything in front of me. That's not what most users see. So if I need to see what my site visitors actually see, I open up a private window and go to askleo.com because I'm not logged in that private window. Now, what if you need more privacy? What if you really are looking for that online safety? Well, to begin with, there's no such thing as absolute, but you do need to take additional steps. You may or may not use private mode for this. It depends on how safe or how secure you consider your own computer. But to protect yourself online, you need to do things like perhaps use a VPN, use Tor, use a completely different computer from a completely different location. It depends on exactly what it is you're concerned about. But the bottom line here is private mode protects what's stored on your computer and nowhere else. Hope that helps clarify exactly what it's all about. For updates, for comments, and for links related to this topic, visit askleo.com/27929. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.